I use FreeRTOS a lot in my Pico applications. I use it in combination with C++. Now that potentially opens conversations about C++ efficiency versus C on a Pico, and I'm not going to go there today. C++ objects encapsulation helps me structure my code, and for me that's enough. A friend asked me about working with dynamic memory using the new and delete operators in C++. By default, they won't use FreeRTOS's heap. I want to talk through how to configure FreeRTOS so that the C++ objects are all allocated from FreeRTOS's heap. FreeRTOS comes with 5 different memory models, and you could add your own as well onto this. Of these, heap 2 to heap 5 let us work with dynamic allocated memory. Heap 1, we can allocate memory, but you cannot free it. Now that's enough for a lot of apps. Generally though, the Pico is quite capable, and so I tend to use heap 4 for most of my applications. The memory model on the Pico is contiguous, so there's no reason to use heap 5. So with FreeRTOS, instead of using the inbuilt C commands of malloc and free, we use the macros pv port malloc and v port free to work with our dynamic memory. That's great, and for a C context, or for a lot of C++, that works really well. FreeRTOS, if we enable it, also has capability to look at heap stats. So we can use the routine vport get heap stats to look at the available heap space in bytes, the number of free blocks, the number of successfully allocations that have happened, and the number of frees that happened. I use this quite a lot during development because it helps me confirm that I haven't introduced any memory leaks. I can see how the code is actually allocating and freeing, that we are generally have a stable amount of heap space in my applications. If I want to use C++ operators and C++, then I will want to be able to use new and delete to create dynamic objects. Now that, of course, is going to go back to standard approaches for doing that, not using the FreeRTOS heap. And that's the issue, and that's where this video comes from. This video is sponsored by PCBWay. PCBWay are a friendly manufacturer of PCBs, 3D printing, CNC, sheet metal fabrication, and injection molding. Everything I need from a partner in my builds. I use PCBWay the most to produce PCBs for my projects. They quickly turn around a new board. Often the board I design one weekend arrives in time for me to solder it up the next weekend. So how do we configure new and delete to use FreeRTOS heap rather than using the standard heap? Well, that's really quite easy. C++ allows us to override the standard operators new and delete, and to do that at a global level. You can also do that in a class, so we could actually have specific classes that were only using FreeRTOS, but actually in this example I'm going to do it for everything. So I've written a C++ file here, CPP memory, and I'm just overriding the 2 new operators and the 2 delete operators. And we just need to really compile this into our build. So I'm going to place this file in my port folder for FreeRTOS kernel, along with my FreeRTOS configuration file and a couple of other utility files that I need to get FreeRTOS working. So we've already seen what this CPP memory file does. That's got the new and delete operators in it. We've also got idle memory defined, which is a standard one I've been using for a while in FreeRTOS. This is really about idle task memory allocation. So how memory is going to be allocated for the idle task, how memory is going to be allocated for the timer and how we're doing that. And there's also a Stack Overflow cook in there so that I'm actually getting some debug information if my fail and things go horribly wrong. There are also 3 header files in here. The standard configuration file for FreeRTOS, which says how much memory we've got, and all of the services that we want to turn on within FreeRTOS and the ones we want to turn off in order to save memory. Then I've also got logging levels here. So I've got a logging simple logging mechanism added in, so I'm able to actually log at error, warn, info level, and then change how my logs are actually coming out and what level they're coming out. And that's done by this logging stack H file. It's all just definitions. It's, to be honest, it's actually just underpinned by printfs coming out of my standard output. I've also put in this folder the CMake file, and I've defined that to build in the new way that FreeRTOS has now gone to, building up a FreeRTOS config target. And so that's got within it those two utilities. Whoops, editing them there by accident. So we've got the idle memory and CPU bus memory. It's also got the include files that we need it to be able to pull in. And it's got some project coverage test setting that FreeRTOS seems to want to set. And it's dependent on the FreeRTOS kernel and Pico standard library. So that we're going to use that, and I'm going to include that in my top level CMake file. So my top level CMake file here for the project, and that's going to set where my kernel is for FreeRTOS, where the source is. It's going to include a makefile for that configuration, and it's going to include also the it's going to include my configuration makefile, that's in the port folder, and then the main makefile for a FreeRTOS kernel. So those two bits really are what I'm going to actually include to get this to build. Of course, that means that when I build my project, and I'll talk about the project in a minute, but it's just going to be a test project to give you a bit of a heads up. We're going to have some target link libraries in that. Of course, we've got the standard Pico library, but we're going to use the FreeRTOS kernel with heap 4. And then we're going to also add in the FreeRTOS config. So that's where that operator override is going to get imported in. Now, there seems to be one small little problem with the Pico SDK. You cannot override the operators new and delete because it's already overridden them, unless you turn on exceptions. This is far from ideal because not every application needs exceptions. So why would we need to have exceptions on in order to be able to override new and delete? But today, that's how it works. That's how the build's going to work. So I'm going to have to turn on exceptions, and then I'm able to actually include my own new and delete functions. So everything I've just talked about on all the code, the configuration for ports and those CMake files, that's all in this project, Pico FreeRTOS CPP example, over on my GitHub area. So go check that out if you need it. Let's have a look at the demo then. So my demo application is going to be really, really simple. All I'm really going to do is allocate 100 objects using new, print out what the heap is for them, then deallocate 100 objects and print out the heap again. So I want to just see that my new and delete are actually taking space from the heap or from FreeRTOS's heap rather than the standard system heap, and that's working. So over here in the code, I've got a really simple example. It's basically is going to just launch up on FreeRTOS with a main thread. That main thread is here. And that's going to start up a little blinking LED just so I know that everything's running okay. And then it's going to have a nice loop running forever that's just going to create 100 new objects of my dumb class and store them into an array. And it's then going to print out my stats. It's then going to wait for a second. It's going to then go and delete the 100 items. And then it's going to print out the stats, and then it will sleep for about 3 seconds. So my free stats, runtime stats utility, that's really what's doing the little bit of work around that heap allocation. This is a standard bit of code I keep in nearly every project. It first of all looks at all of the tasks and prints all of those task memory out, but then it comes down and at the bottom here, which is really the subject of this video, it goes and gets those stats for the heap using the get heaps stats function, and it's going to print out how much available heap space we've got, how many blocks that is split into, so if it gets fragmented, how that fragmentation is happening, the number of allocations that have occurred, and the number of frees that occurred. So let's have a look at this running. We can see here that the heap space has been used up due to the new allocation, and then the free or deletes are freeing up space. And that's consistently run after run, giving us the same amount of usage of our heap. So again, we know there isn't a memory leak, but also we know that now new and delete are working off the FreeRTOS heap rather than the system heap. Success! So configuring to use FreeRTOS heap for C++ is easy enough. There is this SDK limitation that you have to turn on exceptions. That does introduce some further overhead on the Pico, but I'm not going to be too concerned about that. The Pico and IP2040 are a powerful little microcontroller, and it will cope for most of my use cases. Thank you very much for watching. Let me know in the comments if this was a useful video. Please do like the video, as that helps others find it. And please subscribe for more videos from me. Goodbye for now.